permits were purchased in 2018, work began late 2018, early 2019. This particular variance is for the front facade of a underlying metal building. Metal buildings are allowed all over the city, however, they're not in the industrial district. The front has to be clad with something, so it doesn't give the appearance of an industrial building in a commercial or residential district. So in order to meet the LDR and get permits, he showed a facade that met code, stucco, and sort of like CMU to get his permits and apply for the variance and let it run its course while he was working on building his building. He is desiring some metal accents as shown in your packets. Staff, that wasn't something that staff could approve in-house. And we're a little bit too big for staff to consider as a true accent in-house. So staff agreed that the variance request and were unable to support the variance request.
I didn't have any, yeah, you just got anything in my packet. It was only,
okay. We didn't get any of that picture.
I apologize.
I want the real picture.
Okay.
Good. I can't.
This wasn't in my.
And I need to. I got a question, Tracy.
Thank you.
And my apologies if they didn't come to this one.
No, you can't tell from this.
I have a question. This may be a stupid question, but what is split flex ceiling?
It looks like rock face. It's good. Okay. Yeah.
I've probably seen it, just didn't know what it was called.
The LDR requires at the front
Right, that's where I'm going with this is, okay, on the east side, I-75 side, go ahead and see it anyway, so we're not really worried about it. The west side is your actual
driveway,
but the way it looks like you're gonna situate the building, is that gonna actually be the front or is it gonna face north?
Well, that one, which I would like some verification from them if possible, because one, that lot is not accessible at all from town. There's a large maintenance there.
Right.
My address is 3050 Daniel Circle, my entrance is on 3050 Daniel Circle. So as for the binding purposes, can you tell me what the front yard would be?
You've heard us talk a real lot at this meeting today about who's at the front yard. Is the front yard the street side? If you live on a corner, it's different. Who has the most amount of footage? So where is your footage the longest? Not St. Augustine.
Well, as far as lot, it's driven by the first stipulation is it's driven by the type of road. Whatever the primary road is, that's considered the front.
The highest grade.
Highest grade road is considered first. And just to clarify, you can have an identified front door, but your actual front door, your drive entry, does not have to come off that drive. You can put your drive entry off either road you want. As long as it meets regulations of traffic, you can enter your property either way.
This is such a unique lot because there's a large embankment on the large embankment on I-75 side. So really the only usable side would be James, and my address, and the driveway. So if the front yard could be determined for building care purposes, then I would probably meet code except for the one side, which I would be willing to delete.
But just to clarify, so you are planning on this front facade to face James Road?
St. Augustine.
To face St. Augustine. So this will face St. Augustine.
So whether you call it side or face, that's right.
That would be the side.
And the road that faces, the side of the building west is going to be facing James Circle.
There is that in there right now, but I can be willing to take that off.
You're sort of a triangular lot. Are you actually going to be parallel to St. Augustine, or will you be sort of facing more than intersection?
We'll be facing intersection. We're really perpendicular to James Circle.
Right. Okay.
Your basic request is the James
Circle. They'll be kind of across the
front
way. They'll be there. Facing
you want that to be your front.
For building material purposes.
For building material. And then the northern side.
Where's the door going to be?
Northern.
On the northern side.
What we call the door we're facing.
Oh, it's going to
be facing
it and walk around.
What we're calling the front elevation is the north side of the building.
You're going to drive off of James and turn in, and then you're going to park in front of the building, and that's where your door is going to go in. The west side is going to be at most have windows or something in it.
The west side is the right side of the elevation on the drawing.
Correct.
Exactly.
Right.
But if you determine definition,
where I was going is the most prominent side that you're going to see, to me, is the James Circle side. And to some degree, the south side, because you will see that other than the trees that are in front of the motel right here where that little holy pond is.
But regardless, the only problem this side with what you're going to do in the current regulations is just this metal siding, right?
Just some metal, like I said, on the second story.
You're planning on backing the building all the way up to the back of the property along this back side here, or will it sit out in the middle? It'll back up to that, to the hotel parking lot.
Yes.
Okay.
I've included some precedents that are very current precedents.
What building is this?
That is a beach home, I wanted to show you all Eric Carpenter's going right now, the residential.
There's not something around here, are there? Like, I do not know this building.
Those are just some metal accents that I found.
To show where.
Show how pretty it could be stone.
How beautiful it is. That's the.
Okay, those are all.
Yeah, two pages.
What kind of this wall do I don't know that building?
And all the local ones are current, remodeled and built.
I know that this tells me real.
They want large crop following here.
Nah, that's wrong.
We want a pitch.
So with this lot, I don't want to drift it.
Are there any other questions about it? No? Is there anything else you want to say?
I have still, but. Well, one, this lot was a very hard lot to develop. I bought it 2016, it took me years to figure out how you can build a building that would be usable for me. I had a lot of issues with the previous owner of that behind me didn't help. But the hotel, the two hotels and I share parking, we share entrances, exits, similar order. But the previous owner did not want me to have an entrance onto my property through here, even though I think I had the legal right anyway to do it since we shared. So in the meantime, I got approval and started the plans, but in the meantime, I found out the hotel sold. The new owner was all in favor of it. He was very excited because this lot's been a eyesore for a long time, just because it's so hard to develop. And it was hard for me. There is hardship here. It's hard for me to develop that lot because it's too large and vacant. So one's completely hidden from the interstate. It's probably 20-foot high. And then St. Augustine's pretty high, so that's probably 15 at max. So me to develop this, originally I thought was so economical. If I build a standard building and put a big metal roof on it, all you're going to see is 100% metal when you drive by on St. Augustine. So how do I overcome that? So we lifted the front and built up to almost 40 feet. And doing that, when I started the drawings, I put the split face block at the bottom and stuff up top. On paper, it looks okay, but in reality, that's a lot of stuff that it would look horrible. It'd be a very plain looking building, not attractive. At 40 feet, you're going to see this building from the interstate. There's going to be a lot of traffic built to see this building. So I wanted to build something that was modern, that attracts not just local people, but I wanted to bring in customers from the interstate. Obviously, we know Valdosta's not the most modern town. I like Valdosta, I was born and raised here, but in other parts of the country, we're not considered modern. So I wanted something that would appeal to a lot of people. And in doing that, I did some research and talked with Mr. Jimmy and some other architects. I found out that metal accents were becoming really popular and really quick, and people are using them in residential homes, and obviously more modern communities, but they're using them on businesses as well. But not only that, the metal is very durable, and it's very water resistant, it's fire resistant. The other building materials that are allowed, the metal holds up many more years, looking sharp and clean. And this is not a normal metal, I probably sample. This is it's kind of a high-end craftsman metal with hidden fasteners. That's one difference between this and a normal metal building would be the fasteners. You don't see any screws or bolts. So the pictures I showed you of the residential homes that have, this is a very similar metal they use on residential beach homes. It's a higher end metal, it has a high end finish on it. So part of my hardship was overcoming that. Adding metal accent gave me a real modern city look that would appeal to, you know, interstate traffic as well. One thing I didn't want to do was create a metal building with fasteners. Warehouse. I don't think this does that at all. I think it does the opposite. I think it creates a real high-end designer look. It's something I think they need about it. There was one correction, I think, in the notes from staff. they were saying there were 1,600 square feet on the front, only 1,409. You took out the windows and glass, I confirmed that with Mr. Giudicello's office, say it's only 1,409. The total square footage on the front elevation is 4983. That's only 28.5% of the front side. If you're calling it the front, so that's gonna have to determine that. If you're calling it the front, it's 28.5%, which is not a large number overall elevation. I know that the side elevation was on the notice from staff as well. That meets code if you're calling it the side. So I'm not sure why that's on there.
All right, any other questions? Thank you. Anybody else here in support?
My name is Jimmy Cone. I'm the architect on the project. My address is 1806 Plum Street. Just a few things. This is a magazine that we get at the office, and I brought a couple of those just for y'all to kind of see. There's a large trend of going to metal wall panels, and we're not using a typical pre-engineered metal building wall panel. The R panel, as we call them sometimes, like you see out in the industrial park. We're using what we call an architectural panel. This is actually a roofing panel, and we're turning it vertical. So you're going to see the panels will be running up and down like this. So it will be an architectural feature of the building. And like I say, it just seems to me more and more I see more metal panels being used, architectural panels. There's some buildings in there that we took around town. Wendy's is using a horizontal panel on their buildings now. We've done the quick lanes right over here at Langdale Ford. We put the horizontal panels over there in that area like that. So we just see it more and more. We thought that it would be kind of neat to have a building that has some metal panels. We really wanted to do the whole front of the building out of metal at one time. We were planning to make some corrugated metal panels, and then we changed our mind and went back to kind of a combination of stucco and these panels like this. So I'd be glad to answer any questions that y'all have about it. Thank you.
Questions?
Thank you.
Right. Anybody here else? Obviously, there's no more support or opposition. Was your office contacted?
We had two phone calls inquiring as to what the signs
mean. Okay, all right. Any other questions from the board? No? Would anybody like to make a motion?
I make a motion that we grant the variance, finding it consistent with the review criteria of special metal.
Do we have a second?
Second.
All those in favor? Very nice.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Yes.
Thank you.
And if you want your,
yeah, just maybe keep one of these for the record.
Sure. Are you holding that?
No, I'm good.
Oh.
I don't need it for that.
Okay. Abstain. Call on your
That's the good one, right?
Is there any other business?
Nathan has been recently reappointed. Nathan has applied 2 years ago.
Ms. Deborah?
Yes, sir.
Mine and Paul's applications, I think you said are heard at the July 9th?
Yes, that was the word that I received as well, sir.
Okay. I'm not sure, I can't speak for Paul, but I am probably not going to be here, so.
So as far as I know, sir, you do not have to be physically present.
Okay, all right. Okay. All right, everybody, unless there's anything else, I think we are adjourned. Thank you.
I think I certainly mentioned that to everybody. I didn't mean to try to be sure.